Welcome back into Talking Fitchburg. Joining me today from the Better Business Bureau right here in Southern Wisconsin, at Tiffany Schultz. Tiffany, welcome back to the show. How are you doing today?
I'm great. Thanks for having me today.
Thank you for joining us. And today we're going to be talking about child tax credits and, of course, any type of new government rollout program comes with scammers, because that's just the way it is now, don't you think?
Scammers follow the news. So there's 36 million Americans who are eligible for this tax credit. So scammers are definitely out there, and we want you to be aware of how they're going to try to take advantage of you.
Yeah. So explain what this tax credit is and when we'll see this coming out.
Starting July 15th, you're going to see some tax credits that are falling into your bank account that are on file with the IRS, the bank account that you use to file your taxes. If you have children under the age of 18, you are going to be receiving some money for them, which is a payment in advance. However, you don't have to do anything to receive this money. If you want to find out more about eligibility, you can go to irs.gov. However, scammers may be contacting you either via phone, email, direct message, text message, any way that they can get in touch with you and offer you, hey, you can get more money from this program, but you need to fill out this application and pay, or we need your personal information for this, to deposit into your bank account. So nobody from the IRS is actually going to reach out to you. You have to do nothing to receive this money. There is no extra money involved. If you're eligible, you're eligible. Scammers are just going to take advantage of that.
There's just no pay to play, essentially. So that just, and pay to play, never works. I mean, that should be a red flag. It's a common. Then this is right in with common scams that we see every day.
Absolutely. But consumers fall for it. You know, if somebody is on the phone offering your money for possibly a government program that doesn't exist, but they say it exists, if you don't do your homework, you could fall for the scam. And we want to keep you safe from that.
Yeah, absolutely. As far as so eligibility wise, for repeating that again, for being eligible, how do you know you're eligible? If money just starts showing up, should you freak out? Go over that part of it.
If you have children under the age of 18, you may be eligible, and eligibility comes from income requirements. What you filed on your taxes for 2020, if you haven't filed 2020 yet, they're going to be looking at 2019. But for eligibility, you can head right to irs.gov and see if you're eligible, because if those payments start falling into your bank account, you're going to want to know where they're coming from. So head to irs.gov and you can get all the information there.
All right, let's talk payment, because this is common with any scams here. How should we expect the payment to come, and what would the scammers do to try to get the money? What could we see as possible of scams, if you will, for those payments?
Well, the payments are going to fall right into your bank account. You could get a paper check for them. You could get a debit card for them. So it's all going to depend on how your taxes are set up. So keep that in mind. The scams that we could be seeing are scammers calling you and saying that you're eligible for more money, but you just have to fill out this application and pay. So they're looking for your financial information, or they could be asking you for your bank account information to deposit the money. They could be asking you for your personal information, your social security number, to scam you for identity theft. They could take different paths to scam you in this instance. However, keep in mind that you don't have to do anything for this money. It's all going to be based on your taxes that you filed for 2020 or 2019. Nobody is going to call you and reach out to you from the IRS.
Yeah, that is super important. Take that with you. If you're anything from this one, there is the government does not call you, folks. It just doesn't happen. Reporting it. Why is it so important, Tiffany, no matter what the scam is, to report it? And who should we report it to?
Extremely important to report. Report it to us at bbb.org/scamtracker. Your report helps us warn others of the scams taking place in the marketplace. And Jeremy, without those consumers reporting these scams, we can't get this information out there. So I take it to you, Jeremy. I take it to the other outlets. We publish it on bbb.org. We put it out there so consumers can find it.
Absolutely. All right. Well, we know what we have to do to stay protected. Like I said, it's just hard to yet common that something new rolls out and it has to be tied to a scam. But like you said, plenty of ways to avoid it. If people do want to find out more information, where can they do that?
More information on the Child Tax Credit Program, that can actually be found on irs.gov. Make sure that you are on irs.gov if you are checking that out, not irs.com, irs.gov. For more information about the scams that could go along with it, head to bbb.org and check on our news tab, and we have all the information there.
Tiffany, thank you so much for taking the time and going through this, and we'll look forward to talking a little bit later in the month.
Thanks for having me.
You bet. We'll take a quick break. More to come. You're watching Talking Fitchburg.